Good morning and welcome back to another video. Well, this is going to be my daily vlog. It's super early. I'm going to get my backside out of bed. I'm going to make some breakfast and I'm going to do a daily vlog. This is something that I've never done and I just thought I'd give it a try because you guys might be interested to see what I do on a daily basis. So, first things first, I need to get my ass out of bed and get some breakfast and then join me for the rest of the day and let's see what we're going to get up to. Okay, so first thing is first, I need to check my weight in the morning, see where we're at, because I am desperately trying to get this weight off and get back into shredded competition again. No, shredded condition for a competition again. You can see I'm still off. Let's get the scales up and check the weight. So my weight is 87.9, which is good because during lockdown my weight went up to 93, which is not good. Oh, it's so cold. Yes, I know I drive a hairdresser's car, and if there is any hairdressers watching this video and you drive an Audi TT, please let me know in the comment section because I get stick for it all the time. Read, as always, there's no eggs in the house, so I'm going to Aldi to get some eggs because I've got nowt for me breakfast. In English, I'm going to Aldi to purchase some eggs for my breakfast. I hope you understood that. Right, just got to Aldi car park, and I am one of those sad people who parks his car all the way in the corner because I hate it when you park next to somebody and they bash your car with their door. So that's just me. I'm one of those people. Trying to find the stuff that I want is maybe face masks. Just a part of life now, isn't it? What am I looking for? Spanish or Italian? I'm gonna go for Italian. This is the bad boy. This is what I love to have with my breakfast every morning with eggs. So yeah, this is the other little tip and top secret that I have daily. I love this just for going to the gym. Okay, so I've got breakfast and got the pre-workout snack for going to the gym. Just need to go and pay for it. You always feel a bit weird walking around in Aldi or anywhere. Talking to yourself. People look at you as if to say, what on earth is he doing? But you get used to it after a while. You get a few raised eyebrows. See, with this mask on, you can't tell what my facial expressions are, can you? Anyway, let's go and pay for this food. Actually, do I go for the 85% cocoa or do I go for the salted caramel? This is what I'm going to go for, salted caramel. Right, so we are back home in the kitchen and Molly is looking guilty for something. What are you looking guilty for, Molly? Was it you? Was it you? Did you do it? You've got that guilty look on your face. Look at that face. Was it you? Oh. Molly, you hungry? Should we make some breakfast? Awesome. Let's make some breakfast, Molly. Smile. So as you can see, Molly's looking pretty guilty for something. I don't know what he's done, but he is looking guilty. Anyway, we're going to cook some breakfast because I'm absolutely starving after my trip to Aldi. So we're going to have a look at what foods I make for breakfast. It is low carb, probably a little bit high in fat, but that's fine because if I'm going to sacrifice the carbs, I'm going to consume more fat. And this is what we're going to be eating. So I am going to just cook some eggs with some fry light oil. And I'm going through a bit of a phase at the minute where I am loving this stuff. You can see the macros are not great, but I love it. Absolutely love it. It makes your food so tasty. And I prefer the Italian one. I don't know how to pronounce it. Prosecco. No, it's not Prosecco. But also salt, pepper, and my other little treat is this. Pancake syrup. Basically, it just tastes like maple syrup. And you might think, well, that's a bit weird. Eggs and your ham stuff, salt and pepper, and then you drizzle this on top. And obviously, I'm keeping the carbs also. I'm using this one because it's got nothing in it. What gets me, it's got no calories, it's got no carbs, it's got no fat. What is it? Just what is it? Is it just air? Anyway. These things never work, do they? Come on. Work. Yes, I am cooking whole eggs. And I know some fitness experts or fitness professionals will be like, oh, it's far too much fat in there. And yeah, it is a lot of fat in these yellow bits. But because I'm keeping the carbs so low, I'm going to increase the fats. Okay, so just in case there's any critics out there and they'll leave some comments in the bottom, I will be having three whole eggs. Then I'm going to crack open two more eggs for egg whites. And it's going to be like a five egg thing. Yeah, you'll see with this on top. Right, so just going to warm this, I don't know what they call this. I'll call it the ham. I'm just going to just quickly pan fry that. Nothing amazing. That's it. And then I'm just going to put that on the eggs. Voila. Bit of pepper. Bit of salt. And then for the magic, the pancake syrup. This is going to transform these eggs and this ham stuff. Oh, it's unreal. Sweet, salty, savory. No, not savory, but you know what I'm saying. Ready for the magic? This is my secret weapon. So there you go. This is the secrets to how I get ripped. And at the minute, my weight, as you've seen this morning, has dropped from 93 kilos. And all because I'm just keeping the diet tight. I'm keeping the carbs down, keeping the fats slightly higher than usual, keeping the protein high. But the main thing is that we're keeping those carbs low. And don't get us wrong, when you're keeping the carbs low, you're off feeling hungry all the time. Just like, oh, I need some carbs. Carbs. Just all you think about is carbs. But anyway, this sweet substitute just helps take away that craving of carbs. Now I'm going to tuck into this and then we're going to head over to XXX Nutrition because I wanted some pre-workout before we go to the gym. And today we are going to, with a bit of luck, fingers crossed, the legendary Ultraflex gym in Durham. They're a big chain all over the country, but these gyms are serious. I've not been to it before, but everybody's raving on about it. So today we're going to head over to Ultraflex gym. I can't wait. So this is the other dog, Poppy. I know it's hard to tell which one is the teddy and which one is the dog. Poppy, do you have any tips on how to get ripped? Okay, that's the answer to that. Just scratch. What a scraggy dog. Anyway, let's head off. Ooh, me big boy racer speaker. I love me music. Right, we're back on the road again, heading to XXX Nutrition because before we head to the legendary Ultraflex gym, I need a pre-workout because I had my breakfast and I sat down to watch TV and I fell asleep. So I think I need something to keep me awake. So off to XXX Nutrition, pre-workout, and then Ultraflex gym. I'm looking forward to this. I'm really looking forward to this. Let's go, guys. XXX Nutrition. Yes, time for some pre-workouts. Obviously, safety first. Yeah. I hate these masks. Right, now, here we are. XXX Nutrition. Let's go and get some pre-workout. I've already got a little snack for later. It is a protein Mars bar, so that makes it okay. Apparently. And later, for just after the gym, my little favourite, salted caramel dark chocolate.
chocolate bar. Now, I know you're probably thinking, you're not really selling it here, Harry. You're supposed to be dieting, but you're having protein Mars bars, chocolate things. But remember, this is only tiny, look. It's a tiny, tiny little bar of dark chocolate. And it's, believe it or not, very low in sugar, but very high in fats, good fats, because it's from cuckoo chocolate. And to be honest, I am never one to have protein bars, especially Mars bar. I'm going to be 100% honest with you, this will be the first time ever I'll have tried a protein Mars bar. I've never tried one. I've never tried a Snickers one, a Mars bar one, a Bounty one, because I just think that if I do try one of these, I'm going to compare it against a real Mars bar and think, ugh. So yeah, this is just a snack that my friend gave us. He was like, yeah, Harry, try one of those. So that's the only reason why that's in my car for, honestly. I don't snack on these things. You know me, I always preach food. Don't replace food with supplements. This mask is not going to stay on my face. Anyway, let's get into the shop and get some pre-workout.
You ever wondered why pre-workouts always have the most crazy names? For example, right, I'm not kidding you, check this out. Brain Dead. That's a great name for a pre-workout. What else we got? What else we got? There's some, what's this one here? Psychotic. Yep, I'm sure that is a good seller. What else we got? Do you know this? The other day there was here, and there were so many crazy pre-workouts. Mega, Eno Explode, Edge, Nox Pump. Kraken? What else we got? What's this one called? That's quite a normal name, isn't it? Yeah, but have you ever wondered why pre-workouts always have... They are like Total War. Bull Nox. I'm sorry, B-Nox. That's the best one though. Psychotic. Or Brain Dead. I'm sure there was one the other day when I was looking at it, it had the most crazy name. And I was like, how could you even, like... Ah, look at this one. Lift Shit. Perfect name for a pre-workout. Because I am going to go to the gym soon and I'm going to lift shit. Aha, what about this one? Full As. Or that one, Kill It. Or that one, Creep. Or that one, Fury. You can see what I'm being told, you. Or Dr. Jekyll and Hyde. We've established that pre-workouts all have crazy names. I'm just going to settle for something normal. Something normal. Maybe it's like this pre-workout. Because that is got a sort of a normal name. And it's a reputable brand. It is by the company who make all these bars here. Grenade. Okay, and if you've ever had a grenade bar, you know that these are tasty. So if the grenade bars are tasty and nice, I'm sure that the pre-workouts are going to be quite sensible and safe as well. I just need to see my friend and owner and also my sponsor, because the guy who runs the shop is my sponsor. So when he gets his bottom out of his office, I shall buy some pre-workout. Until then, hasta la vista. Right guys, that is it. That is the pre-workout done. And now it is time to drive to Ultraflex Gym. I am going to train back, but I need a good motivation song, because it's about a 20-minute drive to the gym, and I've just had that pre-workout, so it's making us feel a bit tingly already. But what I need is a good motivation song to get me pumped up, revved up, ready to go. So I'm gonna have a quick scan through my music Spotify and see what decent music there is. But drop a comment in the section below and let me know what your favorite pre-training song is. Does that make sense? Yeah, okay, so drop a comment, let me know what song gets you pumped up and motivated in the gym. Bear with me one moment, I'm gonna dig out a tune. Oh, can't be listening to that shit. Ultraflex Gym, Durham. Now, just need to find somewhere to park and
My worst nightmare. A full car park. Aha! What do we have here? Ooh! What do I see? I see a fellow TT. Ha ha ha! Oh my goodness, I'm gonna hit it! Okay, so I'm gonna park up next to Saudi TT. They shall respect my car door. Awesome, I'm so excited. We are here now at Ultraflex Gym Durham. Oh, I'm so excited. I get that excited when I go to a new gym. And I've managed to get a space right at the front door next to another Audi TT. And I bet you it's a woman that owns it. Or a hairdresser. Let's go and do some training.
Yes, Ultraflex Gym. You can see that person parked next to me has got style. Please feel free to leave a comment. Okay, let's go inside and see what this gym looks like. First impressions, pretty good. Big.
Solitary diamonds, solitary jewels. Where the bitch is shining, looking like the moon. Say she wanna party, wanna let it loose. Busting out my back, I'm sharing all the loot. It's jumping, let it in. Ooh, I put it out, they come in. Ooh, came up on fun brick. Bought a rich meal, my new watch don't tick. Drippin' Louis V, made a movie and brought another film. It's a dime that I stand this Lamborghini on one wheel.
I'll be honest, this is an absolute awesome gym. I don't know if you can hear us very well because it's very, very noisy. You have to check out this gym behind us, man. It's like every gym goer's dream. Look at the size. This is the cardio up here. Look at it. I'm like a kid in a sweet shop. I love this gym. I think I'm gonna come and train here every Saturday now. Look at it, man, look at it. Wow, what an awesome gym. You know, sometimes when you walk in with gym and you just get blown away by that feeling. You walk in and you're just like, wow, this is like second home. Check it out, man, check it out. I've gotta see it, look at you, look at it. Awesome. Anyway. Let's get back to the training.
Radical decisions, what we always choose. All the dogs is hungry and they selling food. Every time we do it, 10 they hit the news. I don't want it if it's stiffer, if that pussy lose. Running or they gunning cause I got the juice. I've been thugging since the young and brought the word to school. Flooding all the hunnids, we done broke the pool. All this money bring the power, I done made the rules. Sipping on codeine, got my screws loose. Making all this money, got my screws loose. Got a Lamborghini made of pussy juice. Sick, gripping on the wheel, playing in the pussy.
Well, that is back at Ultraflex done. That was an amazing back session. That. So I'm just sitting outside Ultraflex gym now, and I've got to say, Ultraflex, hat off to you. Your gyms are sick. Absolutely unbelievable. You know, when you walk in and you just think, pah. I suppose it's probably the same feeling you get when you go into Gold's Gym in Venice. That gym is absolutely 10 out of 10. Huge thank you to these guys at Ultraflex Gym because, wow, it's Anth Bale's gym, who's a phenomenal bodybuilder. I've actually done a few of his shows before. Anyway, now we're going to leave the gym and it's a 26-minute drive back to Newcastle. And I'm going to have myself a little treat. So I ditched the Mars Bar protein bar and I'm going to go for the Grenade Carb Killer Shake. White chocolate. It's like drinking Milky Bot. But remember, do not replace your meals with supplements. This is a little snack just to get some protein in my body. While I drive home, it's a 26-minute drive home, so I'm going to have this little snack. When I get home, I am going to cook some proper food, which I'm going to show you because today is my daily vlog about what I do. Also, if you're watching this and you're thinking,
Is he just drive around and go to gyms and go to health food shops and just cook? No, I actually have to work as well. Today is my day off work, which is why I'm doing various other activities. So yeah, I do have a job. I don't just do YouTube videos. Yet, anyway. One day, if YouTube takes off and I can just make videos all day, fantastic. But until then, I have to work and earn a living as a personal trainer. So, 26 minute drive home, gonna drink my shake. So, hasta la vista, hasta luego.
There you have it, my next meal. How delightful does that look? And it's just rice, peas, chicken, Spanish sausage stuff, drizzled with a little bit of lemon. And then we have the same food here, a few more meals for tomorrow and at work. I always preach that preparation is the key. So, you know, get your meals prepped. I know it's time consuming when you've got to cook all your food, you've got to faff on, but it makes life so much easier. Get it cooked, whack it in the fridge, and there you go, there's your meals ready for the next couple of days. Okay, guys, I am going to sit down, relax, eat this food, and watch a little bit of Netflix. Just kill a bit of time, let this digest, and that's it really for the day. That is it. I'm just going to have a night at home with the dogs and the kids and eat this food. I'll have another meal later. It's just going to be chicken and rice again. And then my next meal is just going to be eggs before I go to bed. So I think I'm going to call that vlog a day for today. Yeah. Okay. I hope that was helpful. I hope you found it interesting. And yeah. Roll on the next vlog. So until the next video, please, if you enjoy these videos, hit the subscribe button kicking around here somewhere and give it the thumbs up. And also, if there's any videos that you would like to see, whether they're in the gym, daily vlogs, meal preps, let me know. I would definitely love to do some more collaboration videos. So if anybody wants to join me, make a YouTube video, fantastic, let us know. We'll hit a gym, we'll hit a workout, and we'll get some videos made. So until then, take care, stay safe, and yeah, hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. Marvelous. Thank you for watching my daily vlog. I hope it wasn't too boring, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Hasta la vista.